Every year, the MidYiS assessment is used by schools around the world to baseline the starting point of pupils in their secondary phase of education. This assessment provides an indicator of the ability of individual pupils and cohorts at that point in time, along with an objective insight into the likely performance of pupils in future examinations. Once pupils have sat their examinations, we then provide you with value-added information, which compares how your pupils performed in their examinations with other pupils of similar ability, sitting the same subjects. In this brief overview, we're going to take a look at the key information about MidYiS before looking at an example question and then exploring some of the information provided that can be used to support your pupils. For use with pupils age 11 to 14, MidYiS is a standardised, curriculum-independent assessment providing a stable and consistent measure of ability. It can be used to provide performance indicators and value-added information for GCSE, IGCSE and Scottish National Qualifications. The baseline assesses vocabulary, maths, non-verbal ability and skills and can be carried out securely online or downloaded to your local network. A key feature of the MidYiS assessment is its adaptive algorithm, meaning that each pupil follows a personalised path based on answers to individual questions. This makes the assessment more efficient and personalised than a linear sequence of questions. MidYiS takes just 50 minutes to complete the entire assessment and no teacher marking is required. The following questions are examples from a wide range of varying difficulty and are indicative of the style and presentation of questions in the assessment. In most cases, pupils enter or select their answer from a number of possible answers presented on screen. Post-assessment, the information provided by MidYiS can be used throughout the school, providing crucial objective information to help establish and inform your assessment and monitoring framework. From the MidYiS assessment, an individual pupil record is generated, summarising the baseline scores for that pupil. This helps to identify areas of strengths and weaknesses in vocabulary, maths, non-verbal ability and skills. It gives you a benchmark. You can see how the scores for this pupil fares within a large sample of thousands of pupils in the same year group. The key information here being the standardised scores, where the mean is set to be 100. This information may confirm what the teacher already knows about the pupil, or cause them to re-examine their assumptions and adapt their plans. This graph shows the proportion of pupils falling to each of the four performance bands, A to D, for the most current and previous year groups. It allows you to anticipate future trends in expected performance in external examinations, enabling you to respond accordingly. Here we see that the 2013 cohort differs significantly to that of 2012, and so we might expect stark differences in examination performance. This graph shows a pupil's probability of achieving various grades in a particular subject. This is a chances graph for a GCSE subject and is based on average performance of similar pupils in recent examinations. It provides an indicator of what could happen, assuming average progress between the baseline measure and the exam. The data indicates that the most likely grade is a 7, although in reality a range of grades could be achieved. Used alongside teacher expertise, the MidYiS chances and predictive data aid subject teachers to assign targets that are appropriate and challenging to each individual pupil. Used appropriately, some schools use the chances reports to motivate their pupils and to help manage the expectations of parents. As well as providing this information for each pupil in each subject, the same kind of information provides an insight into likely performance for each subject across the whole cohort. Value added is a measure of the amount of progress made by pupils over a certain period of time compared against other pupils of similar abilities in other schools. Here we use the data set to identify whether your pupils got similar grades to pupils of similar ability, whether they did better or not as well. This chart provides a value added measure for each subject. A subject's result is statistically significant if it stretches beyond the confidence limit represented by the background. Where a result is statistically significant and positive, i.e. above the line and outside the confidence limit, this could indicate a department that is doing well and has good practice to share. Where a result is statistically significant and negative, it may indicate an area for improvement or reflect an issue that is already known. Value-added feedback is a fair measure of the progress that students have made. Rather than relying solely on exam results, it takes account of where each student started from and the progress they have made relative to other similar students. That's just a quick look at what the MidYiS assessment provides. It's used every year with hundreds of thousands of pupils to set targets, plan support, and track progress. You can take a look at the case studies on our website or get in touch if you'd like to know more.